The historic market town of Caterham is nestled within the beautiful countryside of the North Downs. Although it dates back to Norman times, the modern town was created in the Victorian era, and as it's just 20 miles south of London, it's now a popular commuter location. Family-run Cullens have just opened a shop that specializes in antiques found from the homes it clears in London. It's run by Derek Hunt.
Cullens started in 2011 as a property clearance business. We've progressed from a sort of a man in a van. We have a shop where we sell the bits and pieces, the upcycle pieces. It's a family-run business. Myself, my mother, my father, my brother, a few cousins, my fiance. So, yeah, a good traditional family-run business, yeah, Cullens is, yeah.
Derek.
Drew.
Hello, mate, how are you?
Nice to meet you. Welcome to Cullens.
I am T.
T. Nice to meet you.
Nice work.
Thank you.
Cool. Right, let's have a look around. Wow.
Yeah, why not? Why not?
So this is the posh side of the house clearance thing.
We should say that, yeah.
That is it. Right, okay. My first couple of weeks in the trade, I was doing house clearances.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
We was just doing little bits of rubbish clearances here and there, and we just went from there, flowered, really.
That can be it. It's very tidy. It's good.
Thank you. Yeah, we try
Well, you can, best. You can see stuff then, can't you? You know.
Yeah. No, we do try our best.
First impressions when I walk in, I think, well, actually, it's all new. There's this all modern stuff. And for a house clearance outlet, extremely smart. You know, they don't look like this usually. They're just piled up, literally, with no prices on them, dirty, as you can find it, which is fine with me. I don't mind that at all. This is a whole different take on it. House clearance sort of warehouses, part of the antiques trade. You know, we need them, they need us. These guys are clearing houses in London. It doesn't actually get any better than that. I'm gonna move some stuff, I'm all right to move things around.
Yeah.
Where'd you get this from?
Drury Lane.
And you bought it there?
Yeah, we purchased from a house clearance, yeah.
This high quality bronze wall cabinet was most likely made in the early 1900s. Its slender sections support large original glass pieces. The fully adjustable brackets are solid cast and nickel plated, allowing the shelves to be moved, and is finished off with a cresting all the way across the canopy. It could be worth around £1,000.
Is it for sale?
Yes.
How much is it?
I've got £150 on that.
On the cabinet?
On the cabinet, yeah.
Sold?
Yeah. We're house clearance, so.
Marvellous. Lovely job. We've been in the shop, I think, a minute, got the pleasantries out of the way straight away. Want to see this cabinet behind me. This cabinet isn't just good, it's really, really good. In completely original condition, it couldn't be any better. Apart from it does get better, because the price is 150 quid. And I think you'd have asked me 500, I'd have paid it. Easily. Don't bite my head off. He's trade. He is making his profit. He wouldn't have put that price on it if he wasn't making profit. This is the sort of the beauty of house clearance, though, isn't it? Because
it is indeed,
you just
yeah.
don't know what you're going to walk into.
You just don't know what's behind that door. And that's what I love about it as well.
With the first deal done, Drew gets into his flow and quickly spots another tempting item.
That one just needs tightening up at the bottom there, I think. The next thing I see is this reading stand. They're called the reading machine, this particular model. It's missing the finial from the top. It's probably had another arm. On it as well, that's gone. There's some screws missing at the back of the timber as well, they need replacing, and the base is loose and falling to pieces.
This adjustable mahogany and brass reading or music stand dates from the end of the 19th century. Supported by a decorative cast iron base, it has an adjustable lectern, brass riser to keep your book in place, and an adjustable arm. This could be worth around £250.
What have you got on him? 160. What can you do on that? Or is it not? Is this purely retail?
No, do 120 on it.
120 sold.
Yeah.
I love that. Thank
Fantastic.
You.
Fantastic.
What they're perfect for these days, some people still use them for music stands and that sort of thing in their, you know, in their nice old country estate. But they look great in restaurants. You know, when you walk into a restaurant, it's got all the menus on it. That's generally what they'll go for.
Before he leaves, there's one more item that's caught Drew's eye, and it'd be potty to miss it.
Transylvanian chamber pot. Yeah. Oh, the things that's seen.
Yeah.
Oh, I need to wash my hand now. No.
Oh. It's made of Vampyrex.
Oh. How much is that potty?
30 quid.
Yeah, go on.
Yeah.
Just to make tea hold it.
This East European glazed jug, or chamber pot, is thought to be from the early 19th century. The simple blue and white design has been hand-painted and is typical of country pieces, which are in high demand at the moment. It could be worth around £120.
The beauty of places like this is, again, they can still have the essence of a house clearance about the shop as well, which it does, you know, because it's a real random mix, isn't it? There's all sorts of stuff in here. Down on a low shelf, there's a blue and white pot, handled pot. Very attractive. Filthy, but very attractive. Any sort of blue and white ware I can generally sell, and the more country it looks, the better, the more naive, really. So the printing on it and the firing and everything, the glaze is very, very simple, very country. And there's a fabulous and unique charm to this stuff. And what really sells it to me is I turn it over and it's got stuck underneath in sellotape. It says Transylvanian Potty 1820. Well, I'm buying it just for that alone. I don't care if it is or it's not. It's a great story.